for some time. As far as NDRF is concerned, in Orissa and in West Bengal, a total of 37 teams have been deployed, out of which 17 are in deployment right now, with 3 possible additions in West Bengal, and that will be 20 teams actively deployed and 17 teams on standby. So to repeat, in West Bengal and Orissa, a total of 20 teams will be actively deployed by the end of this day, with 17 teams on standby. In Orissa, the deployment is in 7 districts and a total of 12 teams are deployed. In West Bengal, the deployment is in 6 districts and a total of 10 teams are deployed. All the teams have either reached the locations or are about to reach. The teams which have started in the morning today will be reaching by evening. All the teams which have been deployed and have reached have started the awareness campaigns. As can be understood, this is a multiple challenge, or at least a dual challenge, because this is a cyclone in the time of COVID. So we are facing a double challenge, so to say, and the awareness drive is accordingly tailored for awareness both on the front of COVID-19 as well as safety from the cyclone. We have started interacting with the and coordinating with the local administration, the district administration, the state government agencies for active evacuation from the possible impacted areas. All in all, NDRF is fully geared with all the equipment and all the paraphernalia to face the situation, out of which 17 are in deployment right now, with 3 possible additions in West Bengal, and that will be 20 teams actively deployed and 17 teams on standby. So to repeat, in West Bengal and Orissa, a total of 20 teams will be actively deployed by the end of this day, with 17 teams on standby. In Orissa, the deployment is in 7 districts and a total of 12 teams are deployed. In West Bengal, the deployment is in 6 districts and a total of...
Meanwhile, located itself around 780 kilometers down south of Paradip, and is moving in a northerly direction and is likely to move further in a northeasterly direction later. It is, as per the estimation, in this sea, it may convert itself to a super cyclone, meaning thereby that wind speed will be more than 230 km per hour.
और हिमालय पर्वत साफ दिखाई दे रहे हैं। दिल्ली, मुंबई, हैदराबाद, चेन्नई जैसे कई महानगरों में वायु की गुणवत्ता में भी काफी सुधार हुआ है। कल कारखाने बंद होने से नदियां भी साफ हो गई हैं। इसी संबंध में केंद्रीय पर्यावरण मंत्री प्रकाश जावड़ेकर ने सभी राज्यों के मुख्यमंत्रियों को पत्र लिखा है, और इस पत्र में उन्होंने लिखा, अब जब हम सामान्य जीवन की ओर वापसी कर रहे हैं तो इस स्तर को बनाए रखने की कोशिश करनी चाहिए। राज्य सरकार को प्रदूषण नियंत्रण के नियमों को सख्ती से लागू करना होगा। नदियों में औद्योगिक कचरा और उत्सर्जन पर नियंत्रण रखना होगा। जनता को जागरूक करने
लाइकली टू मूव नियरली नॉर्थवर्ड फॉर सम टाइम एंड देन इट विल मूव टुवर्ड्स नॉर्थ नॉर्थ ईस्ट वर्ड्स एंड अक्रॉस नॉर्थ वेस्ट बे ऑफ बंगाल इट विल क्रॉस वेस्ट बंगाल Bangladesh coast between Digha in West Bengal and Hatia Island in Bangladesh during afternoon or evening time of 20th May. And it will cross as a very severe cyclonic storm with maximum sustained wind 155 to 165 km per hour in gusting.
It has gone up significantly in Pakistan of Bright Kashmir. You think this is something to be worried about for India as well?
Well, this happens every year. Army Chief has already given his opinion on the issues. We monitor these things closely, and whenever action is required to be taken, it gets taken. So there's nothing to worry about this. These things are monitored closely by all the agencies concerned.
And if required to take out any terror camp,